Although the constant of proportionality may sound like a complex term, if you can wrap your head around it, it's not as hard as it seems. Before watching this video, I would suggest you have some basic knowledge on what a proportional relationship is. In a proportional relationship, you have two variables, y and x. A proportional relationship is written as a ratio, which is y over x. For example, 100 miles every 2 hours. Here, your y is 100 miles because it is dependent on your x, which is 2 hours. When finding the constant of proportionality, all you have to do is evaluate the ratio, or simplify the ratio, since a ratio can be written as a fraction. Remember, a fraction line is a division sign. This equation can be written as k equals y over x, or k equals y divided by x. The letter k represents your constant of proportionality. So, to find k in the example 100 miles per 2 hours, just divide 100 by 2. We can see that the constant of proportionality is 50. I think of it as kind of like finding the unit rate, which would be 50 miles per hour. Now let's demonstrate how to find the constant of proportionality if you're given a table. When using a table, we can also use the constant of proportionality to see if a relationship is proportional or not. This may sound confusing, but I'll show you what I mean in a second. So let's say we have the following table using the same example. As you can see, our x is hours and our y is miles. The first column in the table is 100 miles per 2 hours, like we started with. The second column in the table is 200 miles per 4 hours. The third column is 400 miles per 8 hours. We can see that in both rows that the amounts are being multiplied by 2 each time we go a column further to the right. Now let's find the constants of proportionality of these ratios. In the first column, we'll divide our y, which is 100, by our x, which is 2. We already know that this evaluates to 50. In the second column, we'll divide our y, which is 200, by our x, which is 4. If we divide 200 by 4, our constant of proportionality is 50 again. For the third column, we'll divide 400 by 8, which is 50 as well. In this example, we know that the relationship in this table is proportional because the constant of proportionality is the same every time. If you're using a table and the constant of proportionality isn't the same every time, then the relationship is not proportional. To prove that this relationship is proportional, I'll make a graph using these points. If you already know about proportional relationships, you'll know that a proportional relationship must start at the origin on a graph, which is point 0, 0, and must form a straight line. If both of those things aren't true, then the relationship isn't proportional. As you can see, on this graph, both of those things are true. In this graph, the reason I started at the origin was because I knew that if the relationship wasn't proportional, then the line would bend at my next point. As you can see here, it didn't bend, so the relationship is proportional. Thanks for watching, and remember to subscribe for more math and other subject-related videos.